Hi, my name is Mikhail Naganov. I'm a software engineer at Google working on Chrome for Android. In this video, I will talk about building modern mobile websites using Chrome for Android and Chrome Developer Tools. Not surprisingly, a mobile website runs in a browser just as a regular website. But it's more than just a simplified version of the desktop website. A modern mobile website takes an advantage from the fact that it runs on a mobile device and integrates itself tightly with it. Chrome for Android and other mobile browsers offer APIs that allow websites to implement first-class touch support, tactile feedback, and provide access to the current device state such as orientation and geolocation. This makes possible to create websites that are very close by the look and feel to native mobile applications. The question is, what are the advantages of implementing your application as a mobile website versus implementing it as a native application for mobile platforms? First of all, you have to deal with the single platform, HTML5, which is implemented uniformly across different mobile platforms. This is a great saving of efforts if you compare it with the need of porting your native mobile application across different implementation stacks of various mobile platforms. Also, languages used in the HTML5 platform, JavaScript, HTML, and CSS, are high-level languages that make programming a lot easier comparing to native applications programming. Browsers are hot at the moment, and they are all evolving very fast. New features are added literally every month. Having ported Chrome to the Android platform, we intend to follow Chrome's release program and provide beta and developer channels for you to preview the new features. It's also simpler for users to get access to websites as they require no installation procedures, and updates to new versions are invisible because they don't need modifications on the client. From the security standpoint, websites provide a different model than native applications. They run in a browser sandbox. The user is being asked by the browser to confirm a permission for an action. For example, to access user's location. As soon as the action takes place, instead of providing a long list of permissions during application's installation that nobody usually takes care of. There are several points that you need to keep in mind while planning the development of your mobile website. I will name the most important of them. First of all, there are a lot of different devices in the wild. We have cheap phones with small screens on one side of the spectrum, and high-end phones with high-density screens and tablets on the other, and everything you can imagine in between. Not mentioning that every device can be used in a portrait or a landscape orientation. Obviously, your site needs to be ready for that and might need to provide different layouts for different types of screens. Handling touch input requires a different strategy comparing to traditional keyboard and mouse input. On one side, it's more intuitive, but on the other, it's less precise than using a mouse input, and typing on an on-screen keyboard is much slower than on a physical one. Mobile devices have less computing power than regular computers, and the power consumption question is vital for them. There should be no waste of precious CPU cycles in your application. Network connectivity might vary depending on where your user is situated. Your website must be prepared to work without any network connection. Happily, most modern browsers support offline storage and can inform your website about the current state of the network. There is a problem that a lot of mobile users are stuck with outdated mobile platform releases running old versions of browsers. But as I have mentioned earlier, we intend to shake this situation up by updating Chrome for Android as often as the desktop version. By the way, it's a good idea to get the most from your desktop Chrome browser debugging features while developing a website for mobile. Developing on a desktop is more convenient and involves less setup steps. What mobile features can be tested using Chrome Developer Tools and third-party tools on your desktop? Surprisingly, a lot. In recent versions of Google Chrome, you have an ability to override user agent strings with the ones used on mobile platforms. And what's even more important, Chrome Developer Tools can automatically adjust your window size to the size of the device screen. Also, it's possible to emulate touch events with your mouse. Multi-touch event simulation is also feasible, although setting it up is more involved, and perhaps it will be just easier for you to test it on a physical mobile device. It's awesome that you can develop and test a lion's share of your mobile website functionality without even running an emulator. It would be ideal if you could do everything on desktop, but unfortunately some of mobile environment-specific features should be tested on real devices. Of course, you can provide the same interaction experience on desktop, just because your desktop or laptop computers feel differently from mobile devices. For your website to provide intuitive interaction, you must work with a real device and strive to make the interaction as natural as possible. Obviously, hardware platforms of mobile devices are significantly different from desktop boxes, and actions that are performed with ease by powerful desktop processors may significantly slow down their mobile siblings. Not mentioning that the GPU acceleration pipeline is different on mobile devices. As with regular websites development, you need to test your site on real browsers, because even despite the fact that many of them are based on the same rendering engine, differences in versions and vendor patches may significantly affect the behavior of your website. And the last important point is network connectivity that I have mentioned before. Although it's possible to try to simulate different networking conditions on your desktop by inserting artificial delays into network packets processing or dropping packets, the setup of such tools is usually complicated. While on a real device, you can easily switch between Wi-Fi, 3G, and 2G network connections to model network conditions that end users might have. And now let's proceed to the most exciting part of this video, demos. I will be using a laptop computer and a tablet running Android Ice Cream Sandwich with Google Chrome for Android. Here we have a simple web page that draws a rotating Chrome logo using HTML5 canvas element, and you can interact with this Chrome logo by touching it. You can slow it down its rotation by putting your finger on it like this. You can also resize it by holding it with one finger and dragging the second one like this. Let's see what can be tested on your desktop by using mobile feature emulation available in the latest version of Chrome Developer Tools. If you're a web developer, we strongly encourage you using Chrome Developer Channel releases or Chrome Canary releases to get access to the latest features that we have in Chrome. Now I'm running my page on the desktop version of Chrome. Let's open Chrome Developer Tools, then open their settings. And here you can see the user agent group of settings. By using it, we can emulate screen sizes of mobile devices and emulate touch events using a mouse. After I set my user agent setting to Nexus S and have device metrics override enabled, you can see that the tab running the application will have the same pixel dimensions as the screen of a Nexus S phone. And they can switch between portrait and landscape orientations by pressing this button. Touch events emulation is also pretty straightforward. You just need to check the corresponding checkbox, and that's it. Pressing the left mouse button will generate touch start, touch move, and touch end events. Setting up for remote web debugging is really easy. First, you need to make your website accessible to your mobile device. To achieve this, I will connect my laptop and my tablet to the same Wi-Fi router. And I have a website running on my laptop, and in order to connect to it, I need to know my laptop's IP address. Now I'm entering the address in Chrome on the tablet, and here is my application. For setting up remote web debugging, we need to perform several steps. These steps are documented on the Google Developers site. First, you need to connect your device to your host machine using a USB wire. Then, you need to enable USB debugging in the device settings and enable USB web debugging in Chrome. Chrome for Android will open a port for remote debugging, and you will need to forward this port to your host machine in order to be able to connect to it. You will need to have Android SDK platform tools installed on your host machine. And after that, you will be able to navigate to the remote debugging landing page from your Chrome browser on desktop. So I'm connecting my tablet to the laptop by USB. Now I'm going to the device settings and enable remote debugging. It's also recommended to enable the stay awake setting, so your screen will not go asleep. Now in Chrome, I'm going to the settings panel and enabling remote debugging there. After that, your mobile device is all set up. On my laptop, I'm issuing a port forwarding command, and my local port 9222 is being forwarded to the remote web debugging port opened by Chrome on the tablet. So when I'm navigating to localhost 9222 on my laptop, I'm getting straight to the remote debugging landing page and can start debugging. So let's check how our application works on the tablet. To our surprise, the touch handling code that was working pretty well on the desktop doesn't behave as it should on the tablet. Let's investigate that. In the developer tools, I am going to the event listener breakpoint sidebar and setting a breakpoint on the touch move event. Now when I touch the application, the debugger breaks into my application execution at the entry point of the event handler. Now I'm using developer tools live editing feature to insert some login into my event handlers. As I press Command S, the code is being sent to the device. Now I'm switching to the console tab, and here I can watch in real time how my event handlers are being invoked. You can see, as I'm touching the screen, I see the console messages appearing in the console. Now we can see the problem. Our application only receives a touch start event, a couple of touch moves and no touch end. I'm running a developer version of Chrome for Android, and it seems to have a problem with swallowing touch events. This doesn't happen in the desktop version of Chrome, that's why on the desktop our application was working fine. Actually, what you anyway need to do in the touch move handler is to call event prevent default in order to prevent browser from attempting to scroll your content. This prevents the touch move event from being processed by the browser, and it just passes the event to our application. So now, after sending this change to the tablet by pressing Command S, the application should start working properly. Yes. It works, and we have finally tested the behavior on multi-touch. It also works. Great. Now let's try to take a CPU profile of the same application running on desktop machine and on tablet and see if we can spot any differences. As drawing a Chrome logger isn't a very CPU intensive task, I'll add a code that displays 10,000s of points on the screen, setting their color depending on whether they get into the Chrome logger or not. I'm selecting the line of code and invoking evaluating console command on it. As you can see, the frame rate has dropped significantly. Now I'm doing the same thing on the tablet. Here the frame rate drop is even more visible, as the CPU is slower than on the laptop. Now let's take CPU profiles on both devices and compare them. First, I'll make the size of the window on the desktop browser the same as on my tablet. 1280 by 800 with help of developer tools. Then I'll make radiuses of Chrome logos to match. I will look the size in the console for the mobile side and copy the value to the desktop side. Now I'm starting CPU profiling for the site running in the desktop browser. Okay, we are done. Now I'm doing the same for the mobile browser remotely. Done. Let's compare the profiles side by side. What you can see is that time shares for the same functions are significantly different between desktop and mobile versions. The function named program is the native code of the browser itself. This may happen due to several reasons. Different CPUs, different versions of the V8 JavaScript engine used, and differences in x86 versus ARM code generation in V8. This experiment confirms my statement that running and debugging your site on a real device provides a great insight and reveals new aspects of the site behavior that can be seen while debugging on desktop. Thanks to Chrome for Android USB web debugging feature, the experience that you have is as good as for the desktop version of Chrome. Thank you very much for watching this video. For your convenience, here I'm providing some useful links for you. First of all, we have a page on the Google Developers site that contains the setup instructions for remote web debugging. If you want to know more about using Chrome Developer Tools, there is a section on Google Developers site for you. If you will be happen to be on Google I/O, I would highly recommend attending the Chrome Developer Tools session for a deep dive into advanced developing techniques. That's it. Thank you and goodbye.